Anything you say into this will reach hundreds of thousands of people. Do anything you want with it. Have fun.
I have ligma!
Hey there, my little tadpoles. Today we're going to be talking about Jaiden Animations. Because talking about The Odd Ones Out is kind of scary because James intimidates me for some weird reason. Jaiden Animations is a storytime animator who, if you haven't heard of her yet, well, shame on you. Go watch her content right now. She's honestly one of my favorite storytime channels, but that doesn't excuse her from being critiqued. So I'm gonna do that. Welcome one and all to Let's Talk About Jaiden Animations. To start off, on August 5th, 2014, Jaiden made her first official video, Sneaky Advertisements. The videos themselves were rather short, and the audio quality really wasn't that good. But for her first video, it was okay. Everyone has to get started somewhere, and this is the video that set the bar for her future videos. Between 2014 and 2016, Jaiden would polish up this chibi-esque art style that she had been using. But near the end of 2016 and moving into 2017, the art style would shift into a more human-esque model with a regular-sized head. Other than that, everything else in her video would become quite consistent. The backgrounds, if any at all, would just consist of simple line art. Any color outside of black and white would be next to non-existent, and she would always lip-sync in her videos. The only animation to exist at this time would be image transitions as well as PNGs that slide across the screen. The fluid lip-sync might have given the illusion of movement, but it would be nothing like her future videos. It wouldn't be until September 3rd, 2017, in a video titled Things I Do That Adults Probably Don't, where Jaiden would consistently have other animators helping in her videos. It was at this point between September 3rd, 2017 and October 1st, 2017, where her videos were probably at their best quality. Come October 1st, 2017, in a video titled Things I Felt Guilty About, the notice and quality has drastically changed, and this is both a good and bad thing. Now, I'm not going to argue that the videos themselves have a lot more going on in them and they're a lot more enjoyable because, well, they are. But I would like to point out the fact that in her Things I Feel Guilty About video, moving onward, the animation begins to become a lot more noticeable between animators. There's a big difference in line thickness between the animators, and sometimes the animations themselves would go from extremely fluid to a bit more choppy. And all of this becomes a lot more noticeable when you move into her more recent videos. The more animators she picks up for her videos, the more noticeable these problems become. Even in her most recent video, Burnout and Overworking Yourself, it's really easy to spot which animators change at what parts in the video. Creating a more consistent model sheet is something a lot of studios, both official and unofficial, end up doing to make their final product look as polished as possible. And these model sheets don't just consist of character sheets. They also consist of what line width, character shading, and colors to use in each project. Speaking of colors, that's the second biggest issue in her videos. For the majority of the time, there's usually no color in the videos outside of characters' hair colors. But every now and again, characters and objects with color will come into her videos and it becomes quite a standout, mostly because she uses black and white for the majority of the videos. So anything with different colors that come into the scene just kind of look off-putting. One moment there's simple characters with absolutely no color to them, and then the next moment there's a fully colored character with fully colored backgrounds on the scene. And it can be very jarring for the audience that's viewing the video. Let me put it this way. Let's say you're watching a movie that was made in the 30s. Everything's black and white and staticky and, you know, old-timey. And then all of a sudden, just randomly out of nowhere, everyone's in full 4K HD color resolution. And then, just as fast as it came in, everything's back in black and white. You'd probably be confused and not really know what happened. And this is the same for Jaiden's videos. Now, there's not really much advice I could give outside of this one major thing. Consistency. Now, when it comes to any form of media, consistency is definitely the key. Especially in animation. And double especially in collaborated animation. Consistency is a key factor in any professional animation studio. If you're not willing to stand up and meet the criteria for a project and conform to its artistic rules, then you're going to get kicked out of the studio immediately. At least in a professional setting. When it comes to something like YouTube animation and collaboration, There's a point where professionalism and creative freedom don't really mix. Now, I'm not saying people who want to work in a professional setting on YouTube have to give up their creative freedom, no. They just have to know when to conform to style and rules, and be one with the collaboratory effort. If you're not willing to work as a team and try to be similar in a collaboratory effort, your art's gonna stick out like a sore thumb, kind of like Jaiden Animations' videos. By creating a more consistent model sheet and telling people what line width, color, and shading techniques to use, the final product is going to look a lot more clean and professional than if there were a few rules set and people just went ham on their art styles. Another thing to work towards in a collaboratory animation is working with the weakest artist and finding a common goal that everyone can meet. Now, this doesn't sound like much, but it can drastically improve the quality of your videos by just changing how everything's put out. For example, take a look at Domix's channel. At first glance, you might think that it's just one person animating the videos, but if you look a little bit deeper, you'll find out there's 5 people working on the same video. They work in a way to keep everything consistent with each other, and not one animator is noticeably different than the other when it comes to the videos they put out. And with that, the end result looks a lot more polished and professional than would normally happen if everyone just used their own art style for the video. There's also very rarely any color in the videos, and when there is, it's saturated down to make it fit with the black and white theme. That way, it allows them to use color without it popping out and looking way too jarring compared to the black and white colors that they normally have in the videos. If there's anything to take away in this video, I'd say that artistic collaboration requires both parties to agree on some point and rules. If there's no set rule or standards, then the finished project won't look as polished as it could be. And this goes for big YouTubers such as Jaiden Animations as well. Overall, she's a great channel and her animators are amazing. They just need to learn how to work together a little bit more. If they worked on that, then her channel would be pretty. But in the meantime, my name is Staxlotl, and as always, a big shout out to XRoPlays for editing this video. If you like what we do, you could donate to us on our coffee. If you want to hang out, we have a Discord. Both will have links in the description below. And in the meantime, I hope you all have a good day.